If I told you Kentucky Fried Chicken is offering 6 Kentucky Nuggets and a special bumper-sized pack of chips for just $3.45, plus you get a free can of Pepsi, you'd have to admit that's the best value snack in town.
But then if I told you you could get 6 pieces of chicken plus 2 special bumper-sized packs of chips for just $8.95,
and you also get 2 free cans of Pepsi,
you'd have to admit it's the best value meal in town.
Bumper snack, $3.45.
Bumper meal, $8.95.
The chips have to be quick.
Oh, 1988, you and Jono were like Hamish and Andy, weren't you?
We were sort of Hamish and Andy before Hamish and Andy. Jono and Dano, Roy and HG. We were before Roy and HG, we were before Club Veg. So we all came out of Triple J, Club Veg, which was... I invented the internet and the mobile phone.
And the selfie.
And printing.
The selfie, well before there were such things as selfies.
Hamish, if you're watching, this is what you're going to end up like.
Yeah. But slightly thinner. I must reiterate, 1988 was when we were doing Saturday Morning Live on another network, myself and Dana.
You were just a bigger star.
I got huger. But anyway, that was only the kilos. But what I just said about Australia Day, that year, 1988, was amazing. It really, everybody got magnetised by the fact that we were proudly Australian. We did Peter Fayman, who you'll be talking to later on, got all the TV networks together, the ABC, SBS, 7, 9 and 10 all worked together on the largest TV event in Australian television history. I got to go to Darwin, I got to go to Mount Isa with my beautiful then girlfriend Margot down the mine. It was the longest cable run in television history, a mile down a mine. It was like someone had said, where should we send Jonathan Coleman? I know. Let's send him down.
But you got out.
Yeah. But I must say that Australia Day event was just amazing. I'd never seen so many. We all felt very proud because there it is.
I know that Ray and everyone else really wanted to come down because it's so much fun here in the mine. But you guys actually don't wear any underwear. We're not wearing any knickers at all. No knickers. We won't tell anyone. It's a bit of a secret. We thought we'd sing Happy Birthday Australia.
Yeah, so basically it was so loud down there. It was amazing. They had to stop drilling. But it was a 24-hour, 24/7 mining operation in Mount Isa. That's myself and my girlfriend in the middle there, Margot Fitzpatrick. It was just fantastic.
And John, I'm deadly serious about this because I remember I grew up watching you. You were just the biggest thing in the world. You had your own TV show, of course.
We did Late Night with Jono and Dano, which was like a bit of a Letterman rip-off before Letterman. Saturday Morning Live, our executive producer.
Look at your mullet.
I know. Rob McKnight used to come every Saturday morning without fail, especially if Carly was on.
So she came on the show.
She'd been on the show many times. She came on many times because she was friendly with our boss then, Christopher Skase, and so Kylie and Danny came on.
And Kylie was still doing Neighbours.
And in fact, when Kylie first did Locomotion, which had the video, which you showed a bit before, had a budget of $5,000. Andrew McBiddy in Melbourne, I think, directed it for $5,000. Lots of favours. Mm. This is her own dancers that she brought back from England, I think.
Luggage.
I'd already said on the radio on Triple M that Kylie's a lovely person, but I think she should stick to Neighbours because she's never going to have a hit record.
You're a good predictor.
That was the album. Yeah, so Kylie, we were very proud of Kylie, but also magazines in 1988, there was lots of different things going on in the news.
Kay Fisher, I remember this.
Wow.
Age 14, she won the Dolly Cover Girl of the Year. Myself and Dano used to write.
Who later engaged to James Packer.
That's right.
But it was broken off. Her mother's Prue Goward, who's a minister in the New South Wales government.
That's right.
And of course, New Idea, Women's Weekly, all the magazines were huge with royal stories. And I'm sure Ita would reiterate the fact that when you put a royal on the front cover,
you put Diana on, it'd sell like hotcakes. Wow.
Were you at the Weekly still?
No, I was editor-in-chief of the Sun Herald in 1988.
Wow.
We used to host the Dolly Cover Girl Quest every year. And I tell you what, I'm so glad there wasn't Facebook or any of those pictures then, because there was the lawyers are now saying
that Dolly Cover Girl competition, same competition that launched the career of Miranda Kerr as well. It was certainly
and you know who one. the editor was of
it was Lisa Wilkinson.
Who was then dating a guy called Clive Robertson.
There you go.